I would like to know which book changed your life.
The book that changed my life was Black Fox Thinking by Matthew Syed. And it's because it made me see that you can change your mindset and that there is a different way of looking at the world. Because it's all about having a growth mindset and embracing the fact that it's okay to fail. What matters is how you handle that failure. And if you sit and dwell on it and feel shitty about it, then you're never going to grow as a person. But if you analyze what went wrong and look forward, then you're going to become a much stronger, more resilient person. And since reading that book, I have learned a lot. I have changed a lot as a person. I am more resilient. I have had some very painful lows since reading that book. And I didn't see a way out. But I kept in the back of my mind that nothing is permanent. Everything changes. The good stuff ends, the bad stuff ends. And remembering that was really important to me finding my way out at the end of last year when I was really struggling. And that book just really reminded me of how much I still have to learn and how the way I was raised and the way I was taught to think growing up is something that I can change. It's not something that I can stick to. And I've certainly proven that multiple times, particularly like some of the brain training I've done to help with my chronic pain, for example. And yeah, it kind of opened a lot of doors for me. And it also taught me that storytelling can work really well in nonfiction. And the problem was the type of nonfiction I was reading rather than the entire nonfiction genre. Kind of like sometimes it can be the type of fantasy you're reading is not the right fit for you rather than the entire genre.
Well, I mean, that book does sound very good, so I'm not too mad that you already had an answer, but I'm still a little bit mad that you already had an answer.
I will say the same every time, because I know most people, there are a lot of books that have made a difference to them, and I understand that, but for me, there is not a book that has impacted me more on a emotional and intellectual level. Just yawn at my sorry. Really deep and meaningful answer. Just
I can't control needing to yawn. I'm sorry. But no, that's good. I actually have the book on my shelf, so maybe I will pick it up and actually read it. But, you know, maybe I'll read Gone Girl one day. So
I think the thing is, you have to be in the right mindset to read it and heed its lesson. Because I've recommended it to people before who do need to learn about a growth mindset. And they read it and went, yeah, that's nice. They learned fuck all from reading it because they weren't ready to hear it. And if you're not ready to learn about the fact that failure is not fatal, then it's not the right book for you. But if you're ready to build resilience and really fight through the difficult times, the really painful times that feel like they're going to destroy you, then it's a good book for you to read. But I do think that most people who read it will just sit and go, yeah, that's nice, and not take anything away from it.